Hi guys, welcome to the video. This is part four in the DevFus Foam series, where we're trying to make a BAE HAWK, or the US Navy version, the GOSHAWK. And in this part, we're actually going to cut the foam blocks out, and then we're going to actually place the blocks on the CNC machine and get the machine to actually cut out the fuselage parts for us. And if you stick around to the end, there's a little bit of a freebie giveaway. Don't get too excited, but it might be interesting to you. So this is a setup I used to get my foam blocks to the correct size as specified by DevFus Foam. And all it is a simple bow with a car battery charger and a jig to guide the wire down with a nichrome wire. Now the battery charger I've had for years, and all I do is I plug this into a electrical socket with a house dimmer switch, and I can control the amount of current going through to the bow. And I found through testing, usually around about 2 to 3 amps works quite well. So I just get it to about 2 or 3 on the meter there, and then you can hear it sort of sizzle as you go through. So just move the battery charger out of the way, and I'll give you a dry run of how this works. All it is a simple jig with just made of some scrap wood, some chipboard, and the two pieces that are square and screwed to the board, and just another line at the front. And all I'll do is just put it on there, connect the battery charger up, get to about 2 or 3 amps, and just let it drop by the weight of the bow. So what we need to do here is place a piece underneath, otherwise what will happen is you'll get down to the bottom and the bow won't go all the way through. It will just leave be stuck in the foam. So it's important to get the foam size correct, especially the height, because what can happen is when it's doing its rapid moves, in this piece of foam here we're going to cut 3 parts, so when it's cut the first part, then it moves, does a rapid move up to the next part. But what can happen if it's still in the foam a little bit when it does that, and the wire isn't quite hot enough for a rapid move, it can sometimes drag on the foam and lift it. So I always find it's best to get the foam near enough the correct size. Length doesn't matter too much really here, but it's more to do with the height and sometimes the width on wings as well. So I'm just supporting the bow here and letting the weight of the bow and the heat of the wire take it through. And I just lean it slightly forward a little bit like this. I usually do this from in front of it, so trying to demonstrate it on camera, it's a little bit more awkward, but it works out okay, and we get a nice square cut. So once this comes off and we have a look at it, that will do nicely. So what I've done now is I've put some double-sided tape, which I need to take the other side of it off. And this is stuck down with double-sided tape. And I find this is the best way, rather than using weights. So let's just get the tape off. It's a bit tricky on foam sometimes, this. There we go. Right, so on the foam block we're going to cut, I've marked the centre line down it. So this is going to be the end going up near the wire. Now the actual program says that it needs to be 3 millimetres from the, so it's got offset X, 3 millimetres. Because this is longer than we need, I don't think it really matters too much. The main thing to do is to get this lined up. It's not the easiest thing to do in here, so I use a mirror to try and get it right on the end. Keep it held up so it's not on the tape. It's about right there. And then
That should hold it. Yeah. So we're lined up everywhere. Right, at that placed. So we should be ready to go. So we're set at about 2.6 amps on there. So just get a scrap piece of foam and make sure the wire's hot. It is a little bit more awkward doing this when the towers are so close together. Yeah. So this is making blocks 7, 8 and 9 on the BAE HAWK. So we should be ready to go. Oh, one other important thing. Don't forget one of these guys, because the stuff in this foam isn't very good for you. So put me mask on. And I'm working outside in the shed and I've got the window open. You see the window open there and the door's open there. So we've got plenty of ventilation as well. Because the fumes are quite nasty. Right, we're on. Program's loaded up. Let's see what happens. Nothing. Press the wrong button.
So the reason we cut the foam block to the correct size is so when it's on these rapid moves, it's going to come across the top of the foam. And the wire's hot, but at the speed it's going at, it's not hot enough to make a clean cut in the foam. So what it would tend to do would tend to lift it. So it will start to make its cut. So what I've done, guys, is I've speeded up the next section because it's not very exciting watching foam being cut. And it in total, this whole process probably took about half an hour.
So block number 7 cut. Just move it out of the way. So let's have a look at our blocks. So the first thing I do before I take them out is number them up. So we started with 7. And I do it on the middle section as well, because we might want these for when we're cutting the wing slot and canopy slot out to give some support. So this was 8. And 9. We can cut that off down there. So we've got 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 9. So still a few more to do yet. So let's take this. Sometimes take a bit of getting out depending which way the. So 7, 8 and 9, and that's where our fan's going to fit in. So it's not looking too bad, that. There's a few more sections to around about there somewhere. So what I'll do, guys, is I'll cut the rest of them out. You don't really need to see all the others being cut out.
So there we go, 14 formers in all. It took a little bit of time to do them all, but I got there eventually. In the middle there you can see the 64mm fan. And right up the front, the actual smaller parts. So most of it's 60mm, but there's a couple of 30. And then there's a very small 12mm. And these are all the parts we need to make our fuselage. There is a little piece to go right on the end of the nose cone. And what I did here, I just tacked them all together with a bit of double-sided tape just to get a see what it looks like. So obviously it's good, and they still need some smoothing off now. So the next stage is to get the wing slots and tail slots cut out, but I'll do that in the next video because it would make it a little bit too long. So if you feel like having a go at making a fuselage but don't want to lay out for the cost of a license for DevFus Foam 2, then what I'll do is I'll release the G-code for fuselage and I'll just pop it on my website. So there'll be a link in the description to the website, so if you want to go over there and have a look at it. And there's also there's a free ebook as well on how to build your own foam cutter. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you found that interesting, and catch you later.